Hi guys, welcome back. We are starting from where we stopped last time. We saw some of the settings, some of the options that are available on Pop-Up Ally. In this video, we'll see how we'll build our form, we'll design the form. So without further ado, let's get started on that. So we'll go to Style Settings. As you saw in the settings for the display, there was a pop-up one and a pop-up 2, so in the free plugin you can have two pop-ups. So you can have one pop-up, maybe one pop-up can be for all pages, another one for all posts, or you can have one whereby it is embedded at the end of the posts. So that's what we'll do. The first post will be, the first pop-up will appear on pages and posts as a pop-up, and then the other will be at the end of the post. So we'll create this second one in the next video. So for the first one, let's get started with this first one. So the sign up form HTML. So for this, we'll go to MailChimp to get our embed code. So you know how to get here. Just to show you, you'll go to lists, then you'll click here, then click on sign up forms, then you'll click on embedded forms. Just take the code as it is, then come back and paste the code right here. So the name field is merge 3, that's for the first name. Then the email field was named email. So here we have the pop-up template. So let's just take a look at this and see how it will be on our website. So we save changes. Once we save the changes, let's go back to our display settings. Display settings. Then we want this to be a time delayed pop-up. So I will put it at 2 seconds to show up after 2 seconds. Then I'll come down here and say show for all pages and for all posts. And one important thing that I have to do is I want this to appear every time I refresh, so I will use -1 days. Right now I'm doing this because it is for testing purposes. Otherwise I will have to change this number back to 14 or 15 days. So I will save the changes. Once I save these changes, let me go to the website. So as you can see, this is how the form appears. That's how you can create the first form. We go back to style settings and we can see how we can design the form. So what you can see is you can change the background color and the preview is here. Okay, this is just some CSS error with the plugin, but it's no big deal. Every change you make will be visible here. So let's say we change the background color. Can actually give it a blue. Then you can change this text headline, you see your name and all that. To subscribe, you can see that change this. You can write whatever you wish there. So you can have a logo image actually the image would appear here. I don't want to use an image, so I'll just remove that. So to change this, you'll change it here. Introduce yourself and your program. New video tutorials. You can change the text for this in this area. Then you can change the button text. Button text you'll change here. So this is the first time that I think I want a black. So I will select the color. So this is on the footer item. You can add whatever you want to tell your subscribers in this field, and it will be added here. So that's it for the first form. We can save the changes. So let's go back to our website and take a look. So after 2 seconds, there we go. So this is it for this video, guys. In the next video, we'll create the second pop-up so that we can add it at the end of every post. Subscribe, share, and like the videos. Until next time, guys.